this novelette, it's in the format of the modern authors, and I'm the author in this particular novelette, Year of Living Dangerously. The image is taken, actually, from a Tarkovsky film, The Sacrifice, and it's an appropriation of other painters' appropriation of this film that is sort of focusing on the dramatic moment in the film, and we've seen all films and seen all pictures, what's left for image making. And yet, A Year of Living Dangerously sort of points to the last year in my life, and this one takes the cake as the byline. The subline, Full Catastrophe Living, is actually a title from a self-help book. And all these images kind of relate to that idea of this massive transformation where not only the house is up in flames, but the car and everything around it. We're just going through this massive change in this piece. And I'm the author. In this modern classic from Barnes & Noble's format, I've taken the image and shifted it from the original Dracula image, which was actually a grave dug with a crucifix in it. Now, this is actually a pipeline being laid in the ground, and the author in Dracula in this book is Rachel Carson, the contemporary author dealing with environmental crises. The byline in this book, There Will Be Blood, comes from the film that Daniel Day-Lewis starred in that was looking at the oil industry, the emergence of the oil industry, and just the violence, not only environmentally, but between each other in this mining, this extraction business. So this, in many ways, is a response to what was happening at Standing Rock last year. In this piece, it's based on a book cover format from Every Man's Library. The author in this case is Emily Dickinson. The title, Silent Running, actually refers to the stealth movement, and also it's a movie title. Now, as far as the imagery goes, the leopard sort of points to that darkness, the mysteriousness, not only the female, but the artist, and the notion of silent running, of moving quietly within a space and almost being undetected, it sort of creeps up on you. The byline in this particular piece is an actual quote from Emily Dickinson, and the end line, the dark is afraid of her, actually comes from advertising. And so all of these images and texts interact with each other to create this new kind of novelette that sort of speaks of art, speaks of the feminine, and also points to the classic author, Emily Dickinson. In this Every Man's Library format, I looked at Modern Collections format to create this piece. Year of the Eclipse is actually taken from a book title, 1833, The Year of the Eclipse, on Nat Turner's Slave Rebellion. But I've updated it to 2017, being our last year of this major shift and actually a year of an eclipse. The image is taken from a popular Frankenstein book where the head is screwed on backwards. This notion of othering somebody is addressed here. And why are we doing that? Smile on Your Brother becomes the byline taken from the Youngblood song. And Try to Love One Another becomes the final punchline. Okay, this book has a title of Great Expectations based off of Dickens' novel, but I've mixed it up with different authors and titles. This is John Muir, so it really is a comment about environmentalism and our great expectation, basically pointing towards the landscape, which is based on an Albert Bierstadt painting, which is an iconic image of the American West and kind of a symbol for American purity and frontier, and that's at the heart of American mythology, and we have to take care of this. So John Muir, being the seminal environmentalist, kind of points to that direction by making him the author, and our great expectation is what we have to live up to. Now the format of this is in Every Man's Library format, and this design is actually not their contemporary classics, but their traditional classics. So the bylines at the bottom actually prompt the question, does water really matter? And that's what this is all about, this environment, our American West, our American landscape. Are we going to be good stewards of it? The format is showcasing Ernest Hemingway. The Battle for Yellowstone actually is referencing a previous book on Yellowstone, which was dealing with the mismanagement of the national park. It's still under contention. The habitat for the grizzly has just been encroached on, and it's legal to hunt grizzly bear outside of the park now. So this environmental battle is going on to this day, and yet the idea of battling nature, battling ourselves, put on the gloves for Ernest Hemingway. And no subject is terrible if the story is true is the direct line out of the Woody Allen film, Midnight in Paris, that was from the actor depicting Hemingway. So this kind of aggressive action, not only with the grizzly bear, but the idea of Hemingway and how would he approach this? Put on the glove. This particular piece is in a format of modern poetry. Now, there's not one author in the collections, and this is actually the site, is Grand Teton. No Place for Hate and Why Settle for Less becomes the title. In this area here, where the logo for the book usually lies, it says, Every Man's Library of Reasonable Thoughts. How can you come to some of these things that we're doing politically in the face of this beautiful landscape, and what are we doing to each other as well as our landscape? No Place for Hate in Grand Teton.